Overbooked? Exhausted? Need more time in the day? Well, stay with me. I'm going to give you tips to alleviate the stress. Welcome to Mommy's Closet. Here we talk about parenting, children, and family life. And today we're going to dive into managing time for parents and children. It's so important to teach your children about time management because overbooking yourself, packing too much into your schedule, that all can lead to unnecessary stress. And what we want to teach our children is how to live a balanced life. Family, work, and community, all in balance, working together for the good of everyone. So let's get started. First of all, people always say to prioritize. That's the first thing they say whenever they're talking about scheduling. But I'm not going to say that. Not first. First, you need to block out your time. How much time do you really have in your day? If you know you're at work from 8 to 5 every day, then you know that's not time that you have to spend. You know that you need to sleep 8 hours at night, then you know you don't have that time to spend. So let's actually figure out how much time we have. So for me, I'm going to put down that 7:30 to 3:30. That's the time frame that we're going to be working with. That's all blocked out. So after that, we need to have a schedule of what we're going to be doing in the evening. And so for the evening, that's going to be your next thing, is working on your routine. So now that you've blocked out your time of 8 to 5 or 7 to 4, whatever that is, and your sleep time of 10 to 6, now it's going to go into what you have time for in your routine, which is very important for children because routines actually provide structure for your child and for yourself. So for our routine, we have snack and then we do homework. After homework, it's going to be dinner time, preparing the meal and cleaning up from the meal. And then we move on to a leftover homework. So there might be homework for me, which is signing papers from permission slips, going over homework. If those aren't there for me to do, then I allow my children to have educational electronic time. So if they're going to be on electronics, it has to be educational purposes. Then you're going to go into, or for us, I go into exercising and reading, bath time, meditation, and then off to sleep by 9 o'clock for them. And so for me, from 9 to 10, when I go to bed, at 10 o'clock, I have an hour between that time they go to bed and I go to bed. So that's our routine. In that hour, I'm able to work on things that I need to work on that don't involve them. So that's gonna be your second tip, which is a routine. Get a routine. If you have your child in an activity every single day after school and on the weekends, it's gonna be a very tiring, exhausting day. You can still do it, but you still need a routine, and hopefully you're not packing your schedule too tightly. But that actually goes into my third tip, which is learn to say no. My kids, I used to let them do everything. They come home and they say, oh, I want to be a part of this and I want to be a part of that. And it's like, oh, well, they really want to, and maybe they're going to be the next Serena and Venus, or maybe they're going to be the next Picasso, or maybe they're going to be the next whatever. But let's get realistic about our daily lives. We don't have time for them to be in every single activity. Let them pick one activity that they're really excited about and stick with that. And then the next quarter or the next semester, if they want to change, then let them change. But being involved in something every single day, that exhausts a parent who has to run them from all these activities, cook dinner, give them bath time, do homework with them. It's stressful, right? So say no. It doesn't have to happen all the time. And then for the last thing that I would like to say is actually prioritizing at that point. So once you have blocked out your schedule, gotten yourself a routine, and then said no to some of the things that you can say no to, then prioritize those things left over. Maybe when someone asked you to bring in cake for something like that for work, then look at your schedule and see if it can fit in there. Sometimes you can fit in something that's that pops up. And if you can't, again, say no. But if you can, go ahead and take care of that. And so when you put yourself all this together and you manage your time by scheduling everything out, then you're going to find that you actually do have a little bit more time because you're seeing where you can fit things in, if it's worth fitting in. And also take in consideration how long those things take to get to and from. Because if you're taking your child to ballet that's 40 minutes away, that's adding on to the time that you're actually for that activity. You can't say that the activity only lasts an hour if it takes you 2 hours to and from as travel time. The whole activity takes 3 hours, and that cuts off that's a chunk of time in the evening and a chunk of time on a weekend if that's going to be the time to do your normal daily chores. So if you like the tips I provided today, please leave me a comment. Like or subscribe. And also leave me a comment of time management tips that you might have, because I love hearing about those. And also stay tuned for our next video, because we're actually going to be talking about meal prep, which is essential to that time management piece, because a lot of times we don't know what to prepare for dinner because we don't know where to fit it in. Everything takes so long to cook, but if we prep our meals, we can do it. So thanks for watching, and look forward to talking to you later.
And like it up and subscribe.
Bye.